What's up, everyone? It is 2 days before Christmas. Christmas Eve is tomorrow. And I am currently trying to finish up two novellas, Gods of the Dark Web by Lucas Mangum, as well as How Not to Be a Scribe by Zach Brooks. So tonight I'm going to try to really get Gods of the Dark Web pretty much nailed down. hopefully. I'm a bit coarse. We got rain today and I'm feeling like a little under the weather, but hopefully I can have some tea and all this stuff and kind of just be able to work. So I'm doing a little warm-up here. And today's horror paperback is another one by William Scholl, The Pact. I mean, look at these covers. Heard somebody slamming doors out there. Anyway, so I'm just going to read a part of the first chapter here. Hopefully loosen my tongue up and everything and get all the quirkiness out of my system. And you get to kind of hang out and watch me do it if you want. So, anyway, this is called The Pact. The back of the book are there. Yeah. All right. Prologue. New York City, 1941. A quarter moon with the nasty aquiline face of a wizened ghoul or imp was hanging in the sky. It was a cold night, and a rough, yowling wind swept down the avenue outside the Roosevelt Grill. Stephen Russell's wife, Marjorie, 21 years old, looking as pretty as Carol Lombard in her white gown and black high heels and heavier, out-of-character makeup, poked up from her gin and tonic and cocked her head. "Stephen, aren't you having a good time? You haven't had too much to drink, have you?"
"No," he said. "If anything..." Oh, "no," he said. If anything, he hadn't had enough. "I'm just... it's just..."
"It's just you're going to miss me terribly."
I'm being a little more just kind of going for it here.
"It's just that you're going to miss me terribly,"
she said dramatically, putting him on. She smiled and stared into his eyes. Her parents had given them quite a bit of money to go out and paint the town red on his last free night before reporting to Church Street at 10 the next morning. There was no point in trying to get him home early so that he could get to bed at a decent hour. He was too nervous to sleep, and they both knew it. "Yes, I'll miss you," he said. "How did you know?" He lifted her hand to his lips and kissed it. She giggled. Giggled. Always a funny word, giggled. Especially now that I seem to have been reading it quite a bit lately. She giggled. He broke out into a grin, his first genuine smile since dinner. It was difficult for him to smile, for tonight there was nothing but talk of war. They had gone to Toots Shore for dinner, had drinks at the Latin Quarter, and danced for hours at the Copa. But there was no escaping it. No matter where they went, war was on everyone's lips. And that wasn't the worst of it. The worst was that those dreaded words, United States, kept popping into the conversation. In spite of his wife's and others' assurances that the U.S. would not get embroiled in the universal madness, it now seemed people felt it was inevitable.
"All it will take is just one shove,"